Blessed color at last. Now we slip inside our way through.
I'm in your head.
Sure. Sure you are. You sure are. So now we've been infected with what is pretty clearly the Technocyte virus. Same one that is the basis of the infestation in Warframe. So this is going to be interesting.
Marlo. Marlo One. Oh shit.
Go ahead. We have you on the emergency channel.
I've been infected. The shot you gave me, it's not working.
Calm down. Is Mesner dead?
Maybe. I detonated the charges. Are you listening to me? The booster didn't work. I need evac.
I'm putting the hazmat team together right now. I want you to carry on. Rendezvous with our sleeper agent, Yargo Menzik. He's got an observation post on top of the Lazarian Port Authority. He'll have more boosters for the infection. Use them. It'll hold it off until we can get you out of there. Just follow the coastline north.
I've lost all my gear.
Improvise. You were always good at that.
I gotta be honest, the Glaive is basically the reason I started this whole Let's Play in the first place. Just, like, the very introduction of it, which was a very long time ago, I admit. But even the Codex entry said it was a weapon from the time of the first Tenno. And, you know, this is a game that's being mostly a shooter introducing this really rad, you know, throwing weapon. I had to check out the origins, right? And thus... Thus I went down the Dark Sector rabbit hole. All because of this weapon.
Another successful mission. Find extraction.
Ah, the Glaive. Dark Sector's unique selling point. And we have no ammo, so they're gonna force us to figure out how to use it. Oh, some cover is destructible. Learn that quick. We have some destructible glass. Come on now. Headshots are still very good. We can pick up their weapons, but. We are now infected, so...
Swapping knife.
And the weapon does have kind of a max range that's about at the other end of this whole dining hall. Anyone else want some? Oh, hi. Time to be incredibly brutal. And now time to look around for any sources of independent ammunition, because item drops from enemies are no longer at all valuable. I don't think there's any goodies out here. But might as well break all the glass for good measure. We do have some shiny things. We do have currency. You've got to keep your eyes out for anywhere you can get it. Anyone? Okay. The glaive makes a semi-decent melee weapon, but you really only have just kind of the basic swing with it. Also, I keep pressing spacebar when I want to sprint. The bindings on the PC port are a little wacky, but we're making that trade-off in exchange for, you know, mouse look. Left control is the default sprint, and cover engagement. It's great. So now we have an ammo. We can throw the glaive and shoot at the same time. And this is probably the best thing in the game. The glaive is incredibly accurate. It'll just go in a straight line at long range. Unless you're getting shot, in which case it'll wobble a bit. Let's see, is this cover? Yes, it is. For very basic enemies, a glaive and a shot will do just fine. So the glaive being our main weapon, and we're going to gradually unlock superpowers.
You don't understand. This change is inevitable.
If it seems like I don't have a lot of, like, respect for Mesner, it's because I very well don't. It can take a bit to figure out what you're supposed to do. This is what you're supposed to do. You can grab unreachable items this way. And if there's something you're supposed to be doing, they will periodically remind you until you get it done. And now for the part I'm always dreading whenever I contemplate running this game. Finding all the upgrades. Ooh boy. So much for that ambush, huh? The glaive is great because you can just throw it and forget about it and, you know, seek cover for the meantime. Do you have a shotgun? You do. Let's see if we can use this before it's over. Probably not. There we go. They don't want the infected getting guns, you see. This doesn't look good. And the glaive has limited range, which is messing with us a little bit. And now they're throwing gas grenades at us. And to make matters just so much better. I'll dodge when I'm ready, when it's necessary. Oh, yeah, that'll start being relevant. There we go, yeah, this whole place is destructible, it's a big ol' set piece. Parts of it are, anyway. Being very reticent to come inside this time, which is interesting. And I don't really want to interrupt because he's also distracting the soldiers. Another rock, yeah. Whoa! Yep, okay. Oh, jeez. Oh, heck. He's kind of stuck over there, huh? All right. Enjoy that. And very much. Oh, no. Uh-oh. Well, he's gone. Encounter clear. Now, why did the behemoth leave? Well, there was that shockwave of a thing that happened. But that's all we really can tell at this point. Also, before you leave, you would never know. There's like 30 some odd upgrades in the game, and honestly, on my first playthrough, I found like maybe 8 of them. And that can really determine whether or not you get to engage with, weapon customization and the economy. I find it very frustrating. Dark Sector is not a great game, is what I'm trying to get at. So the fact that it kind of has a hold on people's, on Warframe players that have an in on the deep lore have a fascination with this game, and I have kind of a thesis about that, but we'll get to that at the very end. I think this game is very fascinating in terms of, like, how an idea develops, could get sidetracked. And, you know, sometimes how original concepts can be vindicated years on.